Sarvebhyah namaskarah, sarvesham swagatam. Bhagavad Gita yam kinchit anya vishayan prati charcham kurmahe iti atra agatavan asmi aham. So what I am going to talk today is an issue which everybody is seriously talking about, which is about, you know, you got to go and talk to anyone, people say stress management, then, you know, how do I control my mind? Etadrisha vishayaha sarvatra janana manasi vartate, tatra katam nivaranam karaniyam kimva karaniyam iti sarvesham prashna asti eva. Everybody has this question. And as we all know, Bhagavad Gita has everything for everything. So therefore, today I thought I will talk about it. I have two components to it. The first component is, how is Bhagavad Gita, how is Sri Krishna in his conversation with Arjuna actually gives several ideas to even understand the mind. Before I start, I want to ask you a simple question. Suppose I give you a very powerful apparatus. You know, take this particular, it's a very small example. If I give you a very, very powerful apparatus, but I do not give you operation manual at all. There is no operation manual, but there is an apparatus which is all powerful. Then what do we do with that? We actually experiment with it for several janmas. That's all we can do. In fact, the God's greatest creation in this whole Srishti Leela that Brahman has done is to create what is called mind for human beings. Not Sakala Jeeva Rashya, Manushyana. Only for the human beings, this mind is an extraordinarily powerful apparatus, the greatest wonder that you can ever think of, that God created. But God said, I am not giving you the operation manual. So, what do we do now? Now, the only way that we can do is experiment. Now, that is what the first generation of people who actually were born would have done. Today, if you ask me, what do? I say, don't have operation manual. You look at Quora, look at some social media, somebody would have actually said how to use it. In the same way, we have to look at our scriptures. We have to look at our prasthanatrayas, Bhagavad Gita, Dashopanishad. There are lots of ideas of what to do with this mind. That's what we are going to do. So, Bhagavad Gita has two set of ideas. One is to make sense of what is this mind. That itself we do not know. And if we do not know that, it is absolute ignorance with which we are using an apparatus without an operation manual. And imagine if it is a huge machine. So, I am a production engineer. I am a mechanical engineer. Very foolishly, I got into the CNC lab. This happened in 82. Very foolishly, I got into the CNC lab and then put one gear block, a blank to be put. I went and switched on the machine. This entire cutter went there and got stuck. So the operator came and told me, sir, this will cost you 20,000 rupees in 82. Without reading manual, don't touch this machine. So what I am saying, this is very important, otherwise we'll hurt ourselves very badly, which is what lot of us are doing. We are blissfully ignorant. So the first thing Sri Krishna has done is also given us a lot of ideas in Bhagavad Gita to make sense of what is mind. So I am going to spend a little time talking about it. Then he has also devoted one full chapter called Atma Samyama Yoga, in which he has given, this is the only chapter in Bhagavad Gita which is a cookbook approach. Cookbook approach means if you want to cook something, you have to take a book. Step one, put the vessel on this thing. Step two, add some oil. It's called cookbook approach. Step one, step two, step three, step four. Sri Krishna has given a cookbook approach to actually handle our mind in chapter 6 of Bhagavad Gita. So I am going to talk a little bit of that also. Then all over Bhagavad Gita it is there. For want of time, I am only doing these two. That is the only chapter I found. It is clear instructions. How do you sit? What do you do? Where do you sit? How long do you sit? All ideas. How much you eat? How much you sleep? Every instruction is available. If only we know how to use that instruction, we would have gathered the mind. So these are the ideas that I want to share with you today. This is very, very important, and lots of people are trying to use this apparatus without knowing the operation manual at all. So we are all defeated in some ways in life at the end of the day, because, you know, we didn't do anything about it while there are some manuals already available. Okay, so first of all, where are we now? What is the problem? I sporadically took a few surveys. There are hundreds of surveys available. I just took 2-3 surveys to just tell you what is happening. So there was one report which said, what is the top cause of stress in the United States? Because everybody wants to follow United States. So let us be aware what not to follow also. Top 10 causes for stress in the United States, there was a list. To my utter surprise, initially it was a surprise, later it was not. It is only this particular item which is physical, all others are mental. It's only item 5 which is something physical. The rest are all to do with mind. If you think about it, in fact, in 1998, World Health Organization for the first time changed the definition of health. For them, health was always something to do with physical. They introduced mind. Health is a state of mind. Is World Health Organization brought that in 87 or 88. Until then, they didn't. Why did they do it? Because the two killer diseases for mankind today are diabetes and hypertension. Both are related to mind. Nothing to do with the physical body. It is to do with mind. Right? In fact, I think Charaka Samhita, he says, Samadosha Samadhatu Malakriyaha Prasanna Atma Indriya Manaha Swastim. That is the definition. The first part of the definition is physical. Prasanna Atma Indriyaha, Mana Indriyaha, Swastim Ityu Abhi Uchyate, some sloka is there. So, you know, the mind plays a very important role. In fact, I think Sushru Samhita was even crisp. It said, Swasmin Karmani, Swasmin Stane, Stiyate Iti Swastim. You be yourself, you are healthy. If you try to be somebody else, you are actually unhealthy. That's what he said. Swasmin Karmani, Swasmin Stane, Stiyate Iti Swastim. This is the understanding of what causes health. That's what the survey is telling now. Except this, you find many of them are to do with actually mental. I looked at another survey. And what is that survey saying? It is saying 77% of the people experience regularly physical symptoms caused by stress. Physical symptoms are happening because of stress, which is a mental issue. 77%. 73% are saying regular psychological symptoms caused by stress. Irritability, feeling nervous, lack of energy. Right? In fact, there are people in the US today, they suffer from what is called vacation syndrome. They cannot live, they cannot be on a holiday. It is impossible. Holiday is a problem for them. You have to become a workaholic. It's called vacation syndrome. These kinds of problems have happened. So, you know, many of these. 33% are saying we are living with extreme stress. So, kim bhavati atra? Kutra etasya, what is the root cause of all these is something which is extensively discussed in our ancient Indian wisdom. Na kevalam Bhagavad Gitayam. Prachinaihi yetkimapi uktamasi tasarvam asmi eva vishe visheshataya charcham te kritavantaha asmavi etasarvam samyak jnatavyam ado. First we should know what is there. Because they have discussed all these in great detail. Maybe Bhagavata Purana, it can be this, it can be that. There's a beautiful Bhikshu Gita, Dashama, Ekadasha Skande, the Ekadasha Skande, 23rd chapter, Bhikshu Gita. Manayeva, that he says, Kevalam, Manam Kevalam Karanam Amananti Samsara Chakram Parivartaye, there is one nice shloka. There's a person who actually finally says, what happened? There's a big story. I don't want to tell the story, then it gets more time for me. But it says, na devata, na griha karma kalaha. Right? na itara janaha manaha kevalam param amananti samsara chakram parivartayet yat. So even in Puranas you will find these discussions in a big way. So we have to first understand the mind game. Mind plays a huge game. Unless we understand it, this machine cannot be even used, for leave alone handling it in a way. You cannot even use this machine. So you have to first understand the mind game. We all suffer from certain problems. The degree is only different. What is the problem? The first problem we start with, we don't accept the reality as it is. Every moment springs up in life and there is a meaning to it. If we don't want to understand it, we don't accept it actually. We don't accept it. In fact, when we are upset, you will use this framework very, very useful. First of all, we don't accept reality as it unfolds. Pratikshanam kimapi bhavishyatyeva. Kim bhavishyati iti vaktum kopi na shaktah. Still it will happen. That is what life is. Every moment something will come, which will hit you positively, negatively, whatever you want to say. People are not ready to accept it, especially on the negative domain. They don't want to accept it, which means they are actually asking for trouble through what is called mind. The second mistake we all do in life, we want to understand everything around us. Why did it happen to me? Why did it happen? You will be defeated in life if you try to do it. Tat kathapi na karaniyam. Yad bhavishyati tad bhagavat sankalpena bhavishyati iti tadrishasya mana sankalpah yadi vayam svikurmaha uttamam bhavishyati. Tat kimartam yatad abhavat iti yadi vayam tasmin marge yadi vayam gachamaha sarva nashah bhavati. This is what a lot of us do. We want to understand why even I was so good, why did it happen to me? I never thought anything bad. We waste a lot of time like this in our life. I did nothing bad to others, but then why is bad things happening to me? You are just wasting your time thinking all that. You will not find an answer. Sarvam vyartam. Samayasya vyartam bhavati. Atma vyartah api bhavati. Atma nasha api bhavati. Eta sarvam kadapi na karaniyam. Parantu asmakam evam chintanam evam asti. Sada sarvada etatapi vayam kurmaha. Tat kadapi na karaniyam. Because we are not accepting things that unfold, then we start questioning, why did it happen? I studied so well, why did I not get marks? I think you should study so well and leave it. Put a full stop, there is not even a comma there. Moment you put a comma, finished. So we start questioning many events and things that are happening. Asmakam jeevane binna binna vishayaha bhavishyati. Tasya karanasya anveshanam yadi vayam kurmaha sarvam nasham bhavati. Kadapi karanasya anveshanam na kurvantu. Karanani bahavani bahuni santi. Tasvin vishaya asmabhihi na chintaniyam kadapi. Parantu vayam sada sarvada yemaveva kurmaha. Tattu asamichinam bhavati. It's inappropriate. We should not do that. But we seem to be doing. The other thing that we do, all these are related, that's why they're all going here. We start judging everything around us. This is all this mind, mind's job is only this. It will judge this person for his intention, it will judge this event, it will judge this. Kim etat kimartam abhavat, tat kimartam na abhavat, tasya nirnayakah kah, kimartam etadrisham saha nirnayam kritavan. This is how we keep on wasting our time. And then there is one grand thing that we do at the end of it. What we do is we continuously bargain for results and with everyone including God. In a very transactional way we want to live our life. This is how the mind game is. If you read the Puranas, read the Upanishads and all that, it will actually ask you to take a scissor and keep on cutting all these links. That is what you will find. So there is a lot of analytical work our mind is doing. If the mind becomes too analytical, that's why I keep telling in IIM Bangalore, we teach MBA. What is it means? Mano Buddha Ahankara Vardhanam. Manas Buddhi Ahankara. How do you grow it even more and you know become a nervous wreck at the age of 40 or 50 or something? That's what we are doing. That's not a good idea. I think it's not worth. We should not waste time like that. It's not at all worth doing all that, you know, you'll see it later. If you don't see it now, I'm sure these words will ring in your mind one day. So the mind has another very nice thing. What is mind? You know, take I. Every one of us and say I. Now this mind is so clever. Mind has about millions and millions of tags it attached to this I. Millions of tags. I cannot, you know, enumerate the millions, so I'll enumerate some of them. I want you to understand this. I am a father, I am a mother, I am a son, I am a daughter. So you can put, I have put dot 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 because there can be 1,000 such things you can keep on writing. I am a neighbor, I am a this, I am a that, I am a that. This is one tag we attach on ourselves. Okay? This is another tag which we can attach. I am angry, I am afraid, I am envious, I am attached, I am possessive, I am disappointed, I am this, I am that. This is another tag which mind always tries to attach on I. Every one of us. I am dying, I am losing my position, I am left uncared for, I am alone. Again, dot, 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 dot. Mind is very capable of doing all this. This is the third dimension of mind. I. Etat sarvam aham iti tatra evam. This is what is happening. Adhyaropanam bhavishyati tatra. Mithya sarvam. I must do this. I am responsible for this. I alone can do it. It's only I who can do it. I am the creator of this. You know, there's a whole lot of such dimensions, tags also the mind can attach on itself. I am the boss, I am the subordinate, I am the team worker, I am the leader, I am the follower, dot, 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 dot. Put another 100 words there, or all the words, related words you can put, you put that. I am a Brahmin, I am a Kshatriya, I am this, I am that, male, female, bachelor, household, varnashrama, dharma, this, that. You can latch anything on you. This is the job of the mind. All the time, mind tries to do all these and sit silently and laugh at you and see what are you going to do now. This is what this machine is doing to us. So the question is, what is mind management? Mind management is how do you untag? The more and more you tag, you are in deep trouble. So mind management is what? You have to untag. See, people in English, they use peace of mind. Even if there is a small peace of mind, there will be no peace of mind. P-A-E-C-E, peace of mind, will take away P-E-A-C-E, peace of mind. So that small piece is all these tags. These are the tags which makes that small P-A-E-C-E, peace of mind, I. Ahankarasya kinchit tatra adhyaropanam bhavishyati. So our text, our Gita and this and that are actually analyzing this problem. Analyzing what will happen if you attach these tags to you. Tasya parinamaha kaha kidrishasya anubhavaha asmakam, you know, vayam bhavitum arhaha. What will happen? These are all deep psychology. It's all nothing but pure psychology of handling yourself, therefore handling yourself in the context of the people and society around you. Okay, we will take some shlokas now from Bhagavad Gita, which is going to tell you how this mind is playing out. This is a very nice shloka. If you don't know what is Panchami Vibhakti, you read this shloka, you'll understand what is Panchami Vibhakti. Everything is in Panchami. This shloka says from A comes B, from B comes C, from C comes D, from D comes E, from E comes F, from F comes Sarvanashaha. That is how the shloka is. It says, Dhyayato Vishayan Pumsa Sangaste Shupa Jayate, Sangha Sanjayate Kama, Kamat Krodho Bijayate, Krodhat Bhavati Buddhinasha, you know, Sammohaha, Sammoha, you know, Smriti Brahmaha, Smriti Brahmshad Buddhinasha, Buddhinashad Pranashyati. In fact, Krishna says, this is what will happen. Now, this you can apply to any number of situations in your personal life, you can understand this. This is a very generic framework. In many ways you can actually relate this shloka. It says, the mind starts associating with some sense object. This is where the whole mind starts working. Right? I'll give you a simple example. I one day find that, this 250 brake horsepower Porsche car with a sunroof is so good. moment that idea, so it's an idea. Oh, this car looks so good. Now in Delhi area, I meet some of the really illiterate people. They say, sir, hamare paas char bangle gaadi hai. Aadi, four bangles. He doesn't even know Aadi, ED. He says, char bangle gaadi hai hamare paas. Newfound wealth actually, right? So, you know, then you start developing some attachment. Then you start saying, oh, this char bangle gaadi is so good. 40 lakhs only, not much. So, it is good. Now you say, if I don't have it finished, I am finished. So, you have, Krishna says it in chapter 6, I'll come to it. The choice of whether you want to destroy your peace of mind or otherwise is not with anyone else. We often think he upset me. Nobody can upset you. You have to make up your mind and say, I want to get upset now. Uddharet atmana atmanam na atmanam avasadayet. Atmaiva banduhu atmanam atmaiva rupuratmana. I'll come to that shloka later. He says, you decide. So nobody can upset you. You have to decide. So you have to decide that I want this at any cost. Okay? Moment you say I want it at any cost, then your memory and your reasoning will have to blur. Because you know, you are now sort of, that is called sammoha. So by hook or crook you want to get it. So your normal methods of thinking and all that will get blurred. Because you know, this is creating so much pressure in you. Somehow I have to get it. It's true of somehow getting rid of also. Everything is true. Methodology is the same. Okay? So that results in infatuation. The difference between this and this is you go to that extreme level at any cost. You have to add that English word, at any cost I have to get it. That means it is infatuation. Let anything happen, I'll destroy everything and I want it. Because I want it. So at any cost, that is what will happen. And that results in loss of intelligence. Your viveka, your vichara and viveka will all go nashta. Actually, you will destroy yourself in the process. Whether you get the char bangle gaadi or not, I do not know. But you are finished. More or less, you are finished. So, Krishna says that mind has this trap. So, you have to make a very careful choice which way to go. Because it can draw you so heavily that at some point, you have lost control. It has gone on autopilot mode now. You are finished now. It is now deciding what to do. That's what these two nice shlokas in chapter 2. In fact, Sthita Prajnasya Ka Bhasha, there are 18 beautiful shlokas. They are all shlokas on psychology, so to speak. Because it really says how you get affected, what will happen, how do you avoid that temptations. All those are part of that description actually. In chapter 3, Arjuna asks a very interesting question. Atakena prayuktoyam papam charati purushah. Anichyanapi varshneya baladiva niyojitaha. He goes and asks Krishna, Krishna, please tell me, there are lots of times I actually did something wrong. Totally wrong. I shouted at a very close friend of mine. I misbehaved across my limits. But that night or next day morning, this thought will come. Anichyanapi varshneya. I didn't want to really do baladiva niyojitaha. I became a victim of situation. Why did it happen? This is a question mankind will ask 10 million years later. It would have asked 5 million years before. It has an infinite shelf life. Bhagavad Gita and all has infinite shelf life. You can use it any day. This question will always be there. See, the child comes from, the father comes. He had a problem with the office. Something happened in the office. Things were not going well for him. He came home. This two-year-old child with all its native, beautiful ignorance will throw tantrums at you. You shout at the child, download all your stress onto the child or the better half or something. Next day morning, this shloka will come. Or that night, this shloka will come. Atakena prayuktoyam papam charati purushah anichyanapi. Or, you know, I have a good friend. For some reason, we kept on arguing. I overstepped my brief. I'll think tonight. He was a well-meaning friend. Why did I do it? Right? This is, in modern English, they say victim of situation. How do I avoid being a victim? That question was asked. And chapter 3 of Bhagavad Gita ends with 6 shlokas explaining why it is happening. The nuances are explained very carefully. तस्य उत्तरं षट् श्लोकाः तत्र सन्ति विशेषतया तत्र तत्र उत्तरमस्ति ऑल दीस आर अबाउट हाउ डू मैनेज योर माइंड सो देयर इज वन श्लोक विच सेज काम एष क्रोध एष रजोगुण समुद्भवाः महाशनो महापाप्मा विद्धि एनम इह वैरिनम महा अशनः इट विल ईट अप एवरीथिंग यू इट इज लाइक पूर्णाहुति यू पुट एनीथिंग इट विल कंज्यूम इज काम एंड क्रोध आर कमिंग आउट ऑफ व्हाट इज कॉल्ड रजोगुण That Rajoguna will actually consume everything. Then Krishna went on to explain what is this, who, where is the seat of control, how is it getting triggered. All those are explained. I'll take one shloka, which is the shloka for this beautiful Parthasarathi picture. Buddhim tu Sarathim Viddhi in Katopanishad. It says, Yama told Nachiketas. There is a beautiful shloka of that in Bhagavad Gita. Your entire Gita Charya sitting on a chariot can be understood from that shloka. That also tells how do you control your mind. Beautiful shloka. I will take that shloka. He says, Indriyani paranyahu, Indriyebhya parammanaha, manasastu para buddhihi, buddhehe paratastu saha. So there is a master-slave relationship. A is superior to B, B is superior to C, C is superior. In other words, it is actually, it is going the other way. Okay? A is inferior to B, like that you should understand. So he says, Indriyani paranyahuhu. Right? If you take this body is actually inert. Don't think this body can do anything. Body is actually inert, it has no motor. I'm shaking because there is some prana going up and down, otherwise I cannot shake like this. We all know that. So the body is inert. Compared to body, Indriya is better. Why? While I am talking to you, I will now go to World Trade Center in New York. I can think. I can go to those, you know, 1 year I lived in US and then I can think about the Indriyas can travel faster. It is not inert. Whereas a body is inert. So that's why he says, Indriyani paranyahu, Indriyebhya param manaha. The manas can go even more. When I say I will go to New York, my manas is going, not the Indriya. Indriya can go this far. You know, sound, pancha indriyas and so on, whereas manas can travel to unknown places also. So that's why that is better than the indriyas. The motive power is several fold. Then it says, manasastu para buddhihi. The buddhi is better, is more superior to manas. The only problem we have is, instead of buddhi being the master and manas being the slave, we have done the ulta of that. That's where the mind problem comes. That's where the mind management comes. The buddhi becomes slave to manas. It should not happen. The manas must be slave to buddhi. But there is one adhikari for the buddhi also. That is the soul which is sitting. This whole thing is actually here. You can understand this shloka from here. The chariot is inert. Chariot cannot go. Your compartment, railway compartment cannot even move an inch. Only engine can. Even engine cannot move. The diesel or the electric power only can move. They are inert. So this ratha is inert. Right? And you will find there are five horses, pancha indriyaha. They can carry you to places. As much as only the horses can carry the chariot. So the body is like a chariot. Both are inert. They can't move. The indriyas, the pranas, they are all like the horse. That's the horsepower for us. Okay? Now, if you leave the five horses, they will go five different places and this chariot will be destroyed in no time. You will be thrown out of the chariot. So, you need that rein. Right? That rein is the manas. That thread, na? But then the thread also, you should not lose it, no? Somebody must hold it carefully. There is one Partha Sarathi. He must hold it in his hand. That is the buddhi. So in Mahabharata war, the buddhi of Pandavas was actually Krishna. He was the brain behind the whole thing. Now, if all of them are in one place, this person who is sitting will reach where we have to reach. All of us have come because we have a destination to go in life. In life, there is a destination to reach. But if you have to reach, you need all these in that order. This is the lowest in hierarchy. Next in hierarchy are the horses. Next in hierarchy are the reins. Next in the hierarchy are the person who is holding it. And next in hierarchy is the person, you should say, please go this way. So the Jivatma that is inside, its goal is to merge with Paramatma. Tasmi eva marge gamaniyamasti, gantavyamasti, tadartam buddhiyat. That's why the shloka is coming. Now you have to understand the shloka. Indriyani paranyahu, indriyebhya param manaha, manasastu para buddhi, buddheyastu parasastu saha. These are all mind management. I understand what can mind do, where will mind go. Etadrisha shlokaha bahavaha santi Bhagavad Gitayam. Look at this shloka. Nasti buddhir ayuktasya, nacha ayuktasya bhavana, nacha bhavayata shantihi, ashantasya kuta sukam. What is this peace of mind that you are talking about? Krishna is asking. If you are not in shanti, what is this tranquility and peace that you are talking about? So it says, ashantasya kuta sukam. Where is the sense of tranquility? Now he says, abhavayataha na shantihi. If you don't have the right bhavana, shanti will not come. Right attitude to life. Life, I am telling you, you can, you know, clear this exam, you can clear CAT, you can do this, you can do that, you can write the highest, you know, exam that is possible, difficult in this country and all that. You will not go too far in your life. You can go too, really go far in your life when you have the bhavana, the right frame of attitude. That's why abhavayataha shantihi nasti. Then he says, ayuktasya na bhavana. Where is this attitude comes? You should be a very composed person. You must be a person with a composed mind. You should be a yukta. You cannot be a ayukta. Ayukta is a split person, not a connected person. Yuj is to connect. Yuktaha is one who is connected to with what? Connected with the reality, connected with the ultimate. It should be a synchronous existence. That's why he says, nasti buddhihi ayuktasya. A person who is ayukta, his buddhi is not working because he is surrendered his buddhi to the manas. Nacha ayuktasya bhavana. That ayukta will not have the attitude in things. Abhavayataha na shantihi. Ashantasya kutasukam. Yes, where is tranquility and peace you are talking about if you don't understand this basic concept that mind has to be at under the control of buddhi? That's what he is saying in this shloka. And he gives a lot of examples also. Indriyanam hi charatam yanmano anuvidiyate tadasya harati prajyam vayurnava iva ambasi. Just like in water, you have a strong wind. There is a boat in the middle of the ocean, there is a strong wind and there is no, you know, person to control it. It will keep on tossing for 100 days and it will be in the same place again. It goes nowhere. We will reach nowhere in life. This is what Krishna is trying to say. If you don't have the right kind of attitude and control your senses and understand the power of the senses and the mind, you will go nowhere in your life. That's why he says, Indriyanam hi charatam. Simply, you know, this emotion and indriyas are taking me in this direction, I will spend the day today like that. Half an hour later it is taking me here, I will go this way. Another day it takes me like this, I will go this way. You will not reach your destination. After 1,000 kilometers, you are back to square one. Because there is no rhyme or reason with which you are actually going around. Indriyanam vyavaharaha sada sarvada evameva bhavati. Tasmat eva indriyanam hi yasya manaha sada sarvada charantam asti tasya prayojanameva nasti iti Sri Krishna atra vadati. So what he says, unsteady mind, no knowledge of quintessential, cannot meditate on anything deep, right? Wandering thoughts and distracting ideas, no peace of mind, it will become a peace of mind, the other peace, and no guaranteed happiness. This is what he says in this shloka, where he says, understand your mind. Try to understand your mind. Then in chapter 6, towards the end, he says, Krishna, Arjuna asked the question to Krishna, you said some nice, wonderful cookbook approach to meditation, let all be there. I have a very fundamental question, please answer. Chanchalam hi mana Krishna, pramati balavadridam, tasyaham nigraham manye, vayoriva sudushkaram. Just like catching air in the open space, you cannot catch air in the open space, it is impossible. Like that, my manas is like that. Pramati balavadridam. It is very powerful also. Dridam, it is obstinate. It will not listen to me. It is so powerful, it will take me elsewhere. Chanchalam hi mana Krishna. So all the time chanchala. Wavering. Very obstinate. Easiest thing is, one person like me with a bald head went to a sannyasi. He said, "Sannyasi, I have tried all medical things. My hair," he said, "very simple. 1 week it will become all right. Full hair will grow. I have special oil." She was so thankful. "Thank God, I finally came to you." She gave the oil. This person was very happy. Just when he was about to leave, he told him, "But one condition. When you take the oil and apply it in your mind, don't think of monkey. That's all. Mind needs only that. Every day, whatever you do, you'll only think of monkey. Mind has this power. If you say, don't do something, it will say, let me see. This is what you are saying. Let me see what I can do." So every day he takes the oil. What should I not do? Don't think of monkey. Finished. I already thought of monkey. So it's a very, you know, hilarious story. What I am saying is balavadridam. So tasyaham nigraham. I think controlling it is not possible. What are you saying? All these are fine. In chapter 6 towards the end, Arjuna asked two beautiful questions. This is the first question. Two wonderful questions he asked. Second question with which the chapter ends, it's a nice set of ideas. Nahi kaschit kalyanakrit durgatim tata gachati is what he says. So what did Krishna say? Krishna said, asamshayam mahabaho durnigraham chalam. First of all, he entirely agreed with Arjuna. See, if you have to answer a tough question, first you have to jump to the other side. Otherwise, you have lost. Because they think that you don't agree with me. Whatever I say, these are all teachers must know this. If there is a disagreement and something, first jump to the other side. You be with them, then the acceptance is very high. So Krishna, what did he say? Asamshayam mahabaho mano durnigraham chalam. I agree with you 100%. Not even 99.9. 100% I agree with you. You know, controlling the mind is difficult. First he brought all of them into his domain. Then he said, abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha grihyate. There is something called abhyasa and there is something called vairagya. So he said, that's a long drawn process. There is a way, if you do it, I am sure you will be able to come over. Don't worry and so on. So you find these ideas in chapter 6 of Bhagavad Gita. Okay. So far I have talked about understanding what can mind do. Where can it take you? What kind of problems it will create for you? What kind of helplessness you can be in? Eta sarvam asmavihi kinchi jnatam Bhagavad Gita shlokaha dvitiya adhyaya, tritiya adhyaya, shashtyam. Sarvatra asti, samayasya abhavaha iti karanena kinchiteva maya svikritam adhyaya. Yadi sampurnataya yadi vayam pashyamaha, pratama adhyaya arabhya ashtadasa adhyaya paryantam yadi vayam pashyamaha, sarvatra etadasa vishyaha visheshataya pratipaditaha santi eva. Kinchit udaharanartam kechana shlokaha aham svikritama. Now what we will do, we will try to find out what did Krishna say about how do we actually, is there a systematic way by which you can catch hold of this fellow and keep him under our control? Because this is just too much. The kind of things that we saw, this is all not worth. So what do we do? Iti dvitiya prashna bhavati tasya uttaram asmavihi kinchit jnatavyam asti. So the first thing that I want to say is, Krishna clearly said, uddharet atmana atmanam na atmanam avasadayet atmaiva banduhu atmanam atmaiva ripuratmana. First guiding principle that Krishna said is, you alone can lift yourself, lift you to a higher plane, not somebody else. You alone, by your own. And he said, atmaiva banduhu atmanam atmaiva ripuratmana. Whether the mind is your friend or the mind is your enemy is in your hands. You have to make up your mind. You have to make up your mind to decide what this mind has to be for you. This is what he says. Atmayeva atmanaha banduhu bhave, atmayeva ripuhu atmanasya bhavati, atmanaha bhavati. So choice is yours. And he also explained, what did he mean by that? Banduratmaatmanastasya yenaatmayivatmana jitaha. If you are able to take a greater control of the mind, in other words, buddhi must be the boss, mind must be the slave. If you can achieve that hierarchy, இந்திரியானாம் மேனோ மனோபுத்தி இத்தியாதிகம் உத்தம் கிள. ஸோ இஃப் யூ கேன் டூ தட், ஏன ஆத்மன ஆத்மனா ஜித, இஃப் யூ ஆர் ஏபிள் டு டேக் கண்ட்ரோல் ஆஃப் யுவர் மைண்ட், த மைண்ட் வில் பி யுவர் ஃப்ரெண்ட். வேர் யூ கெனாட், வேர் யூ கெனாட் கண்ட்ரோல், தென் இட் வில் பி ஆக்சுவலி தட் இஸ் யுவர் எனிமி. யூ டோன்ட் ஹவ் டு ஹாவ் எனிமி ஃப்ரம் அவுட் சைட். யூ ஆர் கோர்ட்டிங் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஷிப் வித் அன் எனிமி வித்இன் யுவர் செல்ஃப். Greatest destructions, not in only in Puranas. You don't have to read Ravana and Shishupala and, you know, Hiranyakashipu and all that. You can read today's stories and leaders and all that. People dig their own grave. They don't need any help from anyone at all. This is my experience. I have seen it administrator, as an administrator, I have seen in my own organization. I have seen around all that. We have to dig our own grave. You don't need anybody's help. That is what the second line is all about. That is the first thing Krishna says. So when you get into these kinds of problems, you are very power hungry, you know, you want to, you are so worried about position and money and etc., etc., etc. Dehatma buddhi, right? If you get into that definite kind of things, then the chances are your mind can 9 out of 10 times be your enemy. We may not even know it. That is the chance. If you get into this dimension and think life is like this, the mind cannot be a friend. Mind will be a, because all these are anitya vastu. And you think they are nitya and then get into a very complex game and then you only will, it will have the last laugh at the end of the day. Right? Whereas, if you say, this is the paradigm in which I want to understand many things around me, I want to deal with people and situations and so on, with that kind of a thing, mind can become a friend. Atmanah banduhu bhavishyati, atra atmanah ripuhu bhavishyati. So that is why the choice is ours. The choice is not at all with anyone else. The choice is entirely ours. In fact, about 10 days back, there was one 2-hour discussion on happiness in which I was part of it. So I was giving this example. It appears to me that we have manufactured some 10,000 remote controls with us, or maybe 100,000, I don't know how many thousand. And the remote control is very simple. There is one red button and there is a green button. Now what I do is, I distribute the remote control to all of you. I have decided. And what is this remote control? You sit there and press red, I have to become upset. You sit there and press green, I have to become happy. This is how we lead life. I am telling you, you put a photo on Facebook, if people don't see it, they should be upset. Why are you upset? I don't know. Why should you get upset? You put a photo on Facebook, then the number of the thumbs up is less than a few hundred. Finish, 2 days, I don't get sleep. What the hell is going on here? To what level of fragility we have brought happiness? Somebody looked at me, commented at me, which I am not. If you ask me, that person must be upset. I should not be upset. But we get upset. What does it mean? I have already distributed the remote control. And you now tell, enjoy. Whenever you want, press the red button. Then I will go into depression. And this is the greatest foolish thing humankind is getting themselves into. Please collect all the remote control first. Don't leave it with anyone. Why should somebody decide whether you should be happy or sad? Why do you want somebody to decide? You decide whether you want to be happy or sad. You decide. Why do you give it to somebody else? Just because somebody said something, somebody laughed at me, somebody said, made a comment. If somebody made a comment, they should be upset. Why should I be upset? If the day you understand this logic of life, you will march in your life much faster. This is the point I am making. If you take that position, mind is your friend. If you don't take that position, it is only remote control business all over the world. You don't know when somebody is going to press the red color. But the moment they press, I go into depression. This is a very fancy world we are living. So, moment I say Krishna talks about meditation, dhyana yoga, atma samyama yoga or dhyana yoga. So, today I have to be very careful about meditation, because everything about what is told about meditation are wrong today. So, I first put a disclaimer before I get into the word meditation. Meditation is not something which can be bought or outsourced. You cannot do meditation on me because I pay you 100 rupees, you do meditation and I become all right. You cannot outsource. You cannot take an injection and give me the meditation effect. You can give me some other vastu, some effect, but not meditation effect. So this is not possible. Today in Bangalore, I don't know about Cochin, in Bangalore, in the same shop, you have Zumba, yoga, aerobics, because they thought yoga is all about the stretching business. You know, take your leg something and then do very complicated and then ulta karke. And then take your front leg, put it on the right leg, take the right leg, put it on the back side. That's not what yoga is all about. I mean, I am actually very upset with the way we were promoting yoga. Yoga is all about asana. What is all this? Asana is one out of the eight. Yama, niyama, pratyaha, prana, arana. They are all bhakyantra. There is a, you know, antar prayogaha, sarva, chatvaraha santi, panchava santi, trayaha santi. Trayaha, pancha, bhakya, and trayaha, antara. No. So, it is not a physical exercise. It is nothing about physical, because today everybody is told, oh, hypertension, yoga, diabetes, yoga. Yoga is not for diabetes and hypertension, it may be incidental. It can happen, but not yoga is not for that. At least Krishna and Patanjali and all the yoga we are talking about is not for hypertension or diabetic. But it can happen, but we have understood it completely wrong. It's not about maths, it's a big 1,000 crore business, 10,000 crore business running on. Yoga is not about mats or dresses or tiger and deer skin. Simply he said Ajina and Chila and all that doesn't mean there is an industry which has to run. Yoga mat is a big business. Yoga dress, yoga suit, yoga maybe watch, yoga torch, whatever, whatever. And this is another biggest problem with yoga today. 5 to 6 you can do yoga and remaining 23 hours you can cancel all effects of yoga. Because you are seeing everything as a separate compartment. Evam na sarvam militva jivanasya visheha, jivanasya vyavaharasya visheha yoga shastraha bhavati. Na kevalam eka ganta yavat kimapi vayam asanadi ityadikam kritva anantaram yat sarvam na karaniyam yat sarvam vayam kurmaha iti tadrishasya paddhati eva nasti yatra kutrapi anveshayatu. Hatha yoga bhavatu, etat yoga bhavatu, patanchali yoga shastra sutram bhavatu, sankhya darshanam bhavatu, bhagavad gita bhavatu, sarvatra pashyantu. It's not compartment. It's a yoga is a way of life. I mean, people use that word. Way of life means you put that bag and the mat and the you know, put the track suit, yoga suit, and then go and stretch for some time. On the way back, have some high calorie items and then eat and come so that tomorrow you can start the process again. Evam na. Nothing, none of these are, so I am using neti vada, neti neti am vadami. All these are not. This is what yoga is. It is an intense preparation for samadhi. In that the mind will be, that's why the first sutra says in chitta vriddhi nirodha, no? That is the first sutra of yoga sutra of Patanjali. Chitta vriddhi has to be first stopped. If you can't stop, chitta vritti is an endless game. But today, people have not understood. But Krishna has not taken that position. So beautifully, he talked about some nice ideas about yoga. Little bit, I will quickly touch and leave it. So Krishna has spoken all these in chapter 6. Why it is important that you do it in a particular way? Why you, what, even ideas of how to select a seat, how to sit, that level he has gone. It is karunya bhava. Out of compassion, he wants us not to miss the essence. So even small little things as what to do, right? The need to focus the mind, how do you do it? Need to focus the vision as the first step. Specifically, the first step only he has spoken there. Nasikagram, then he puts swam also. We'll come to it later. Yogi injita satatam atmanam rahasisthitaha. Okay? Ekaki yata chittatma nirashihi aparigraha. So first thing he says is, your effort to control and bring my mind under your thing requires aparigraha. Right? It requires ekaki bhavaha yata chittaha. Little bit you have to, you know, exert a little bit of thinking about how do you bring the mind and so on. Ekaki rahasisthitaha. You should be, you know, only when you are a very trained and a very experienced person, you can sit in the middle of the, you know, your what is that? Vaitila, you can go to the Vaitila flyover construction and do yoga, not now. After you have mastered yoga, today it is not possible. So he is giving a very initial, very, very, very important a few things. See, if you put a sapling, please put a cover guard for it for 1 year. Let it become little thick and go to 5 feet, then strike. In fact, it itself will pierce the tree guard. It doesn't need the tree guard anymore. So Krishna is talking tree guard for us. Sukshma vishayaga lagu vishayaha adau asmabhi eta sarvam palaniyam. Idi tadrsha pritya idi vayam agre gachamaha sapalam bhavati. That kind of simple nice ideas he has said. Shuchau deshe pratishtaya. Don't sit in a dirty place because mosquitoes will do the trick for you. Nyunat nyunam. It will remove your concentration. If you read this entire shloka, I find only one message in it. The message is, when you start saying, let me try to gather my mind, the mind is so powerful, it will find the slightest opportunity to get distracted. So all that are told here are those which tries to avoid all those minor distractions. Sthiramasana. If you are sitting in a thing which is shaking, your concentration will go. You will now start worrying about when am I going to fall. Or, you know, what will happen to this, chair? Or, you know, is it slipping and all that? This way, you know, sthiramasana, shuchau deshaha, pratishtaya, na atichritam. Don't go to the tip of the cliff and do meditation because your fear of falling down will be there all the time. Don't go to the patala and do also. The spirit of this whole shloka is beware of the fact that when you start the exercise, mind will find 1000 silly reasons to escape. Mind always want to escape from your control. It will find 1000 silly reasons. He has enumerated only 4 or 5, but you have to understand the spirit of the shloka. The spirit of the shloka is yat kimapi lagu karanam bhavishyati manaha bahirgachatyava. How do you prevent it? Try to take as many precautions as possible. See, students come to me in my postgraduate course, they come. They're all working people, you know, 40 years, 35 years. When I teach this, it has happened in the last 6 years, 7 years. They come and say, sir, I have this problem. They are family people also. There is some problem in the family, there is problem in the office, this. What should I do? When I teach this, invariably they come and ask. I give them a very simple solution. 90% have come back to me and said, it has dramatically changed their perspective of life. I didn't tell anything great. I said, do you have half an hour in your life? They said, yes. If you are getting about 6 o'clock, please get up at 5:30. If you are getting up at 5:30, please get up at 5 o'clock. I am talking, can you give me 30 minutes? Yes, sir. You don't have to do anything. 30 minutes, you just sit and close your eyes. I am not saying do dhyana. I am not saying you put asana like this. I am not saying you have to concentrate on a particular guard or anything like that. I say, can you please sit for 30 minutes? Only condition is close your eyes. You know what happens? After 15 days they come. They tell, sir, we are not able to close our eyes. You try it. It will be the most violent thing that will happen to you when you start. The whole world, your mind will become, it doesn't like. You can't even close, your eyes will this thing. Then they come after 30 days and say, sir, wonderful. Now I am able to close my eyes. There are thoughts running through my mind. 6 months later come and say, sir, I know what to do. So that's what Krishna is saying. Allow, first do small little thing. Reduce, I tell them, you don't have to go to a puja place. Sit in a very comfortable place. If it is Chennai, put a fan, otherwise you will sweat and then everything will go down the drain, including your everything. So don't do that. Put a fan, sit in one place, just close your eyes, don't even ask anything, let any thought come and go. They come and tell me in 6 months, dramatically the world changed for them. That's the power of this. Don't underestimate this. Try closing your eyes, you will understand what I am saying. If you have ever never tried before, you try it. It will be a very violent experience for you. It will not cross. It will, it will do. But you will gather it in about a month. Tatra ekagram manaha kritva. Okay? Yata chitte indriya kriyaha upavishya asane yunjyat yogam atma vishuddhaye. So, first Krishna says spend 6 months, 1 year, whatever it is, gather yourself first. And what is the method? Method is what I said. Don't do any yoga, meditation, don't try any of those. Just sit for half an hour and simply aimlessly close your eyes. It will tell you what to do after 3 months or 6 months. That's what, in a way, it is coming. You gather yourself. We have never gathered. We have let us out through all the indriyas all the time with another remote in our hands. Or another, you know, japamala. All the time doing like this with a cell phone. That is what we are doing. You put all of them out, half an hour, 45 minutes, you just sit. You will know what it means to gather your mind. If you can gather your mind, you have covered phenomenal ground in succeeding in what you do in your life. Tapas will become happen. Tapas means what? Ekagrata. Indriyanam ekagrata. Mana indriyanam ekagrata tapahayati uchite. Ayasangra's definition in Taittiriya Upanishad Bhashya or somebody is saying that. Gather yourself first. Today we are not even giving an opportunity to gather myself. Forget about other things here. First gather yourself. That's what Krishna is saying. Focus. Just focus. Just sit and then get back to you. Then it will tell you what to do. Then he says, Samam kaya shiro grivam dharayan achalam stiraha samprekshinasika gram som dishascha anavalokayan. Then what does he say? He says, Samam kaya shiro grivam. All these three must be in one line. Don't sit like this. Don't sit like this. It should be in one line. The griva, kaya and the shira. Let it be aligned. Okay? Samam kaya shiro grivam. Achalan stiraha. Dharayan achalan stiraha. Sampreksya. Where do you want to see? If you have mastered closing the eye, then you can do many things after opening the eye. Open, what does he say? He see nasikagram, see the tip of the nose. Now we will start seeing somebody else's tip of the nose. So he says swam. Absolutely unambiguous instructions. Because if he had simply said nasikagram, you will find out which nose is a better nose to see now. Mind has this problem. Let's say swam. He said, point your attention to your own nose. Your own nose is under quotes now. That level of cookbook approach, that's what I am telling. They're all very, very valuable lessons actually. Nasikagram swam, disascha avanalok, anavalokain. You know, you sit here and start looking around, what is happening? If somebody is walking there, who is that? Or, you know, some sound is coming, what is that? There is some light here, what is this? There is some insect going there. What is it? He said, don't do all that. And in order to avoid all that, this closing the eye, this shloka is very important before this shloka. Do this for about 6 months, 1 year. Then you come here, you will actually start knowing how to actually take mind under your control. You slowly collect all the, you know, remote controls from the world and say, let me decide what to do with that. I'll trash it. Ketmapi bhavishyateva. Then he talks about even some of the eating and sleeping habits also. That much detail to facilitate us so that we don't miss it out. So he says, na ati ashnaha. Don't eat too much. Yogosti nacha ekantam anashnataha. So don't eat too much. Or don't say that, you know, yoga means I should stop eating. These are all, you know, these are all very unsustainable, I am telling you. I am really telling you. Just because they show in some movie, one fellow is sitting. I mean, he is anyway an artist only, not a rishi, don't worry. So he'll put a long beard and then there is one big ant hill on the top of him. Smoke start coming out of it. Don't get inspired by all that. They are all drama. Okay? You know, you have to use media very well. Vishayam is not that. Vishayam is that do something which is more sustainable. Slowly it will decide how much to eat, how much not to eat, how much to sleep. Don't start with that. These are all failure. So Krishna says moderation is very, very important. It's a beautiful shloka. Yukta ahara viharasya. This is a great shloka to be a great manager, a great person in the family, a great person in the society. Yukta ahara viharasya. Yukta karmasya cheshtasu. If you learn this art, you have mastered, you will be a success in your life. It is all about yukta, ahara and vichara. Moderation is very, very important in life. Extremes and all, you don't go. It will slowly, slowly, slowly take you one day. You don't go. If it takes, let it go. People say, oh, you have to be a yoga and meditation and all, now stop eating. And then start this ugra tapas and all that. All that after some time you may either get admitted or then compensate for it and eat twice the vigor later. If you forcefully do it. It has to slowly, it will take you. He is talking about for the beginner. Chapter 6 is for the beginner. To really gather the mind and march royally on the path of manas control. How do we do? So, yukta ahara viharasya, yukta cheshtasya karmasu. Your vyavahara, everything, let it be. The value is in moderation. Do things in a very moderate way. Don't over jump and do things on either ways. Don't swing the pendulum to the extreme. That will never sustain on anything that you do. The value is in moderation. Yeah? Yukta swapna. Swapna means only if you sleep, you get dreams. So essentially what it indicates is sleep. Have a moderate amount of sleep. Don't say, you know, I will not sleep for 24, but next about 7 days and I will do some ugra tapas or something. And all movie is very good. In any case, they will not shot it for 24 hours. They will shoot it for less than 24 minutes. Don't get carried away by that. Yukta swapna avabodhasya. Don't wake up too much. Don't sleep too much. Don't eat too much. Don't be without eating too much. In other words, Krishna is saying, if you are like that, yogo bhavati dukkaha. Dukkasya haranam bhavati. It will take out a lot of your silly, small, little upsets in life, this, that, everything will go. In fact, that is the value. All of the bigger values and all, we'll see later here. You ask for this now. Every day, there are 1,000 small, little, silly things which is creating problem for me. How do I win over it? If you have win over it, you have actually won the game. The mind game is won already. That's why he says, yogo bhavati dukkaha. So there are about 10, 12 shlokas. I took most of them. Just to tell you, Krishna is telling for a beginner the value of how to control mind. What are those small, little, beautiful steps that we can take? Yadi kinchit etadrishasya abhyasaha yadi vayam kurmaha. Kinchit vairagyamapi yadi vayam prapnuyamaha. Tarhi nischayena chanchalam hi manakrishna pramati balavadridam sarvam satyam na bhavishyati eva. Manas chanchalasya nyunata kartum uttamaha avakashaha kalpitaha bhavet. This is what Krishna is actually telling in this chapter on mind management. So, you know, in Buddhist idea also they talk about the middle path. This is called the middle path in Buddhist idea. Moderation is very, very important. You can't overdo on either sides. That and all in the long run will take you nowhere. It will only destroy whatever little that you have in you. Whereas, if the deha abhimana buddhi is slowly going, indriyanam viryata nyunam bhavati, tarhi aharasya avakashaha nyunam bhavati, tattu anyaya vishayaha. Tat asmabhina karaniyam. Prakriti visheshena etat bhavati gachata kalena tat bhavatyeva. You don't plan for anything in life. I am telling you, don't plan too much for life. Do a best foot forward and then go. That's the greatest lesson in life, I am telling you. Always say, I'll put the best foot forward and go. Do too much of planning. I mean, plan in the sense, of course, you sort of put some goals. Last time we talked about all that. In the last time when we met, I talked about meaningful work. Tasmin sandarbhe asmin vishaye visheshataya maya charchitam asti tasma tasmin vishaye punarekavaram aham na vaktum icchami idane. Anyway, I will just then there are a few more shlokas in the chapter. It's already 4:50. I'm going to stop here. There are a few more shlokas in chapter 6 after all these instructions where he says what will happen if you practice. Very nice shlokas. He says how, you know, the if there is a wind, how you put both your hands and then protect the flame like that. Dukkha sanyoga viyogam. Beautiful usage of the words in Sanskrit. Dukkha sanyoga viyogam. The connection with dukkha has to be severed, will be severed. No, negative usages. I think it is there here. No, it's not. This is what I was saying. Yada deepaha nivatastaha nengate somapa so upama sa upama smrita. Just like, you know, wavering light, if you put a protective glass, the wavering will stop. That is what yoga does to your mind. If you practice a little bit, this chanchalatva will be coming down. See, we have to, let us not worry about some samadhi, imadhi and all, don't worry. You just say, life must be interesting here. Small little things should not upset me. I should have control of myself. I should enjoy what I am doing. I want to go forward. Life is less hassled. That is what it is. Your samadhi and all, we'll talk after some time. Let's not unnecessarily get complicated with that now. They are very practical ideas. Just like, you know, you can protect a lamp, a flickering lamp, the same way the mind will be protected with a good practice of yoga. That's what Krishna is saying. Then what will happen? Yatra uparamate chittam niruddham yoga sevaya. Yatra cha eva atmanam, you know, we pashyan atmani. Sushyati. He starts reveling in his own happiness. In fact, I gave a 2-hour discussion and all that. The idea was happiness cannot be outside. Never ever think that happiness is in a piece of jamun or a, you know, Mysore pak. If the happiness is in a piece of jamun, then if I give one piece of jamun to everybody in this room, and as you eat your jamun, there is a happiness measuring device, if I start measuring it, for half the people it will go positive, for half the people it will go negative, because some people hate jamun, hate sweets. So the happiness is not in sweets. In Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, when Maitreyi and Yajnavalkya, when they are having paraspara, you know, this thing, he says, putra atmanastu kamaya putra hai natu putraya kamam bhavati. Like that, some 20-30 items he says. He says, shrotavyaha mantavyaha nididhyasitavyaha, finally ends like that. The happiness is inside. How do you search for it? That's what yoga does. That's what Krishna says. You will start reveling in that sense of happiness, which we have no idea of what it is unless we try it, unless we if we experience once, it will not leave. And in order to experience that once, one small little, chapter 6 is giving simple ideas which are worth practicing. I think I'll stop here. All those are palashruti of yoga in some ways, I have to say. What will happen if you do this simple little yoga? What will happen? So many shlokas he says. After all these shlokas, then Arjuna asks, all these are fine here. These are all okay. These are all fine. But when I sit, it is not happening. Chanchalam hi mana krishna pramadi balavadridam tasyaham nigraham manye vayori sudushkaram. Then Krishna answered, asam shem mahabaho mano dush nigraham chalam. Vairagina, you know, abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagina cha grihyate. Then Arjuna asked another very practical, never ever think Bhagavad Gita, you know, there is a lot of misconception in the society. These are all dogmatic, useless, unrealistic. But the kind of questions Arjuna is asking are star questions. You know what is the next question he asked? Beautiful question. He said, okay, Krishna, I agree with what you say. Maybe if I do vairagya and abhyasa and all that will happen. But tell me this answer. You told. I faithfully thought that is going to work. I really practiced. I went on practicing. The Janma has come to an end. The Janma has already come to an end. Then he says, I neither got all the nice things that you said I never got. At least I would have enjoyed life. The so-called enjoy life, no? That also, at least I would have enjoyed life. It is like falling between the stools. What should I do? That's the next question. It's a very profound question. It's a practical question. He said, all this is fine. I took, you know, Shraddha in what you said. But the Janma is over. I got nothing. The whole effort has gone. Then, next 5 shlokas, with that chapter 6 ends. He says, no, not like that. Na kaschit kalyana kar durgatim tata gachati. It's an axiom. Good things will never go down the drain. Please understand, that's the only basis we can lead life. Don't look for something tomorrow morning. They are all wasteful. Understand, if you did something good, it will never go waste. It is an axiom, Krishna has said. Na kaschit kalyana krit durgatim tata gachati. Nothing will go waste. Why are you worried? That is why Hindus believe, Sanatana Dharma believes in what is called Punarjanma. There is a continuity. You know, we teach 101 accounting. So after profit and loss account, at the end of it, we have to take the retained earnings, maybe positive or negative, then take it into the balance sheet, and then she will teach, Abha is there, these people will teach. Our Janma is exactly like that. There is a balance sheet, and there is a Sanchita Karma. the Sanchita karma is taken into the capital account, which is called, this is the karma that I have taken this. Then there is a bigger tank, which is my capital and liability and share capital and so on, in which I add all this Sanchita karma, right? It's a going concern. Eta sarvam Sri Krishna tatra vadati. Sashtyam adhyayam Arjunasya prashnaha bhavati kimva bhavati bhavo na iha na amutra. Neither here nor there I got any benefit. What will happen? He says, Sushinam Srimatam Gehe Yoga Brashto Bijayate Atava. He says, nothing will happen here, don't worry. Your effort, I guarantee you, it is a guarantee. Guarantee I am giving. If you did good things, it will not go. It will come. And you will only have a continuity of life, good things. That is the basis on which human beings can live. If you think I have put so much effort and thumb the desk and tomorrow morning I have to get the result, you will destroy yourself after some time. That's not the principle that Sanatana Dharma has taught us. Sanatana Dharma tells us, na kaschit kalyana krit durgatim tata gachati. You put your effort, sometimes it fructifies now, sometimes fructifies towards the end, sometimes fructifies the next janma, sometimes fructifies 20 janmas later. Why are you bothered? Have faith in that. Because it is a very positive, a very rational thinking that if you do it, things will happen. So, Sashtyam Adhyayam Antime Etadrisha Vishayaha Charchaha Bhavanti. With that, chapter 6 ends. I thought I will quickly give you a sense of how Bhagavad Gita has actually looked at mind. Bhavaha Shlokaha Santi. Aham Udaharanartham Kechanaha Aham Svikrutavan. Gunatraya Vibhaga Yoga Bhavatu. Athava Deva Asuri Sampad Bhavatu. Sarvatra Asti. Tasarvam Maya Na Svikrutam. Kimartam Tite Asmakam Purojehi Ye Grantaha Ye Vishayaha Chachitaha Santi. Sarvatra Yetadrisha Vishayaha Eva Santi. This is the core of discussion. This is the core of discussion everywhere in Puranas and Itihasas and here and there and so on. This is the core of discussion. But at the moment, I am actually teaching in my weekly satsang. I am Ayodhya Kandam, I am now there. The amount of pouring that happens between 8th Sarga and 14th Sarga, I thought I will finish it. Three hours, I am not able to move. Because Mantara Varshi is doing, what kind of lamentation Dasharatha is doing, full lessons on mind. Phenomenal ideas are coming out of it. In my weekly session, I am not able to move forward because we are all the time discussing that. Sarvatra Vartate. Bhagavad Gita, I am api asti iti uktva aham viramami santoshah.